Myth Worlds, a mod so darn massive that it not only has had 3 separate videos on it already, it is getting a halfsies out of nowhere here today with one last myth character who wasn't quite available way back when. You two, the Jade Rabbit, and please, please, please forgive this American pleb's obvious mispronunciations as they will be done throughout out of respectable embarrassment, as yes, I not only not speak the language, I went looking at how to say her name, and I feel as if I would just be insulting if I butchered it throughout the video here. So, I'm just gonna stick to what I know. And what I know is that this moon hair has a theme, sticks darn to it, and offers a unique gameplay experience along the way because of it. And what can be better than that? So let us begin with her stats, shall we? At 150 hunger, 120 sanity, and 150 health, Yutu is about as basic as they come, apart from that lower than average sanity, of course. But she will also just have normal modifiers across the board when it comes to said stats and her damage, which does actually beg the question, what does separate her from the rest of the pack? And well, that's definitely gonna have to be her affiliation with all things rabbit, as it will bleed into every facet of her being pretty much. Cause being a jade hare herself, she is a friend to all rabbits, and the little guys won't go screaming home when she gets close. And that is quite useful for what's to come, as well as just for the team, mind you. Well, as long as she isn't actually around to witness the inevitable mass bunny murder, that is. For you see, she loves rabbits so much that she will lose 5 sanity every time one dies around her, be it by her hand or otherwise. But oddly, while she'll still murder them with weapons and such, as you can see, she will actually refuse to twist the little neck while they're in her inventory. So yeah, that might be a little oversight, but given that rabbits don't actually run away screaming for their life anymore, you should note that Yutu can actually just run up to them and pick them up herself without the use of a trap. And here's that useful for the team bit, of course. But it even goes beyond that, as having rabbits in her inventory alone will actually begin a small sanity restoration for her to boot, which is good stuff. Do note, though, that this sanity gain does not actually appear to increase with the number of rabbits that you are carrying. Therefore, it is just advised to simply carry one if you wish, and just keep it fed with carrots along the way. Have fun. Oh, but speaking of carrots, and I'm pretty darn sure you saw this one coming, but still, they are the favorite food of our humanoid bunny friend here, and she will benefit from an additional +5 sanity gain from eating them, which is not too shabby at all. Especially considering how carrots are about to become even more common when you're playing Yutu over that of the others around. For you see, she will be able to rummage through rabbit holes for all sorts of loot, like carrot seeds perhaps, carrots themselves, basic resources it seems, bunny puffs, and more, and will be able to do so again after a short while to boot. And I myself am quite fond of this mechanic, as it just surely does fit the character well now, doesn't it? But that is not all, folks, as several character-specific crafts are also hers to boast about. However, one in particular only adds yet another great layer to the rabbit theme, the ability to create additional rabbit holes. Sure, it seems that the mechanic does have a tendency to crash the game at this moment in time, however I just love the idea, and that there's actual logic behind the craft and the following actions of it. Good stuff. Know what else is logical? Yutu being able to burrow and join her rabbit sisters down under herself. So it is a good thing that she can do just that with her underground walk ability. Simply click on yourself at any time, and at the cost of hunger and sanity, you can travel the world in a whole new way. And during underground walk, you become completely undetectable, similar to things like the bush hat and such, so be sure to make use of it when you can. But do note though, that when hunger gets low or even an earthquake occurs, as yes, you can do this in the caves, the ability will cancel itself, so you gotta be mindful there. Oh, and if you didn't notice or guess it yourself, yes, the ability comes with night vision, which offers a unique way to escape the darkness, which is great, especially when Yutu is very familiar with the moon. So let's talk about that relationship, shall we? And for one thing, our rabbit girl has another character-specific craft that will allow her to be shown the direction of the Moon Palace, a Mythworld's exclusive structure on a very special island. So spend a single petal to spawn a very short-lived moon moth to help show you the way. And for those of you who have watched Mythworld Part 2, you already know who this is and how she can aid us on our journey. But to everyone else, this here is Shang-E, an NPC found within the Moon Palace itself. And Shang-E offers many crafts in exchange of goodwill. And having grown up on the island, you too gains more goodwill faster, as well as being the only character to not be kicked out of the palace come nightfall. Plus, she'll get more mooncakes more often, which is phenomenal because mooncakes are great. Ah, but it goes well beyond that still, folks. Be it on the lunar island or now even down under in the lunar grotto biomes, you two will not feel the effects of enlightenment at all, rendering that blue filter that everyone loves, as well as gestalts, useless. Furthermore, our moon-loving hair here also moves far faster on moon turf to boot. Good stuff. But few last notes here. She will spawn in with what I can only assume is called a pounder. And while it is in fact a weapon that will deal a whopping 51 damage from day one, it is also vital in her pounded powder mechanic underneath the myth tab, another character exclusive mechanic. And I for one am still unsure of the true potential of all this and don't exactly know the extent of the possible ingredients, but in the end, it is mostly just a way to not only heal yourself, but those around you at the cost of 5 hunger each ingredient. Interesting stuff. Note as well that you two will be less impacted by both dusk and night compared to other characters when it comes to sanity drain, which is also interesting. And finally, that heading to the Peach Utopia Island, solving the puzzle in the Strange Mountain, and then cleaning the final room and reading the Myth World's novel will gain you access to special abilities depending on which character you are, even non-myth characters. But at the end of the day, though, they are really all just different takes on the same thing, a flying ability. But still, it's neat stuff, and screw you boat bridges. Oh, and one final thing here. As most myth characters go, we can unlock new skins by playing them, just like how we unlocked new characters by dying in the original games. Playing as you two will grant experience towards this skin here. So, have fun. But there you have it, everyone. Kinda sorta Mythworld Part 3.5, if you want to think about it, with Yutu, the Jade Hair character mod here. I gotta say, just like with Jellyette just yesterday, I really did expect very little, if I'm honest. But after playing with her, I came away enjoying what's been brought to the table with her additions. I love her theme and how her entire character sticks through it and adds layers upon layers, all of which work, and I just love the extra stuff that ties in to the Greater Myth Worlds mod. So be sure to hop on over and give it a try yourself, folks. I'll think you will enjoy it. But thanks for watching, well wishes to all, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.